I'm here today with Mohd Azharuddin Mat Sah, the director of the Greater KL and Klang Valley and Urban Public Transport for PEMANDU. Lots of initiatives in the city about how we are trying to fulfill our ambitions of becoming one of the most livable cities in the world, anywhere around the world. Can you shed some more light on what's been happening on that front?
I think the key part is Greater KL is part of the nation's economic transformation program, where Greater KL and Klang Valley was identified as one of the 12 NKEH, National Key Economic Areas. Greater KL has an aspiration to grow its population from 6 million in 2010 to about 10 million by 2020, and obviously to partake actively in the nation's economic growth. In that context, Greater KL has identified what we call about 9 EPPs. One of it, as you rightly mentioned, is MRT. In addition to that, like in many cities around the world that have rivers that cross the city centre, we actually have two, which is Klang and Gombak rivers, which unfortunately at the moment is not being utilised or leveraged for its potential. So what the government has done is actually to firstly clean the river for safe for recreational use. That is highly critical for us. Well, that's what we're all to do, actually.
On the private sector front, lots of investment in retail. I read somewhere that Malaysia, in fact, KL is home to 3 of the world's top 10 largest shopping malls by lettable space. You know, how much of a draw is that to residents or investors?
I think that is a huge draw. Because if you look into the main, you know, if you're just here in the area of Wan Utama, it's probably, if I recall my facts, 4th largest mall in the world. The point is that you want to give options to the residents in Kuala Lumpur and Klang Valley.
Well, apparently KL now supplants Hong Kong or Shanghai as one of the top shopping destinations around the world. You know, when you talk to people, do they cite these attractions as a big draw for the city?
I think the part is that, you know, if you are an investor, what you would like to have is actually, as we mentioned earlier on, livability in the context of how do we make KL exciting to the person living in KL. So that's the part that, you know, we want to attract for people to invest, make the business here, because they said, hey, it's cheap to open business here. We've got the talent to open business here. You've got connectivity. We're improving on infrastructure. Plus, we are also in the context of we're open towards arts and culture. Mm-hmm. The third part is that about tourists, you know, attracting people to come. And Malaysia, if I recall, is the 9th most visited country in the whole world. We're targeting, you know, tourism is part of our NKEA. We're definitely targeting a lot of visitors to come this year and obviously years go ahead. But the part is that when you come tourists and, you know, they're all over the world, when they come to Kuala Lumpur, they see that KL is a microcosm of Malaysia, where they can understand what, you know, the different cultures and heritages and also livability.
Well, from a geographical standpoint, Malaysia, in fact, KL is right smack bang in the centre of ASEAN.
Yeah.
600 million people, $3 trillion of combined GDP. Again, from a hubbing standpoint, from a tourism standpoint, are these cited as big magnets as well?
I think it does. We need to position, and we are positioning Malaysia to be the epicentre of growth. Because not only in terms of location, we are strategically located, but also because of the mix of cultures and heritage and religious openness that we have in Malaysia.
So we've got this greater impetus to be fully developed and fully high-income status by 2020.
True.
You know, how much of a proportion, or how much of a contribution is KL to Malaysia's wider fully developed status objectives by 2020?
I think if you look at the numbers from a population point of view, if you aspire Kuala Lumpur to have a population of 10 million, and by 2020 you expect Malaysia's population to have maybe about 30-odd population, we'll probably have, Kuala Lumpur have one-third of the nation's population. That signifies is a talent, it's a magnet for talent, it's a magnet for investments. I think the last study that we indicate, it, you know, contributes about 30% of nation's economic growth.
I was talking to Mohd Azharuddin Mat Sah, the director for the Greater KL and Klang Valley and Urban Public Transport for PEMANDU. Thank you for being on the InvestKL Conversations.
Thank you.